Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to my channel. So in today's video, I'm going to be continuing with my hashtag Explore Sneha's V Closet series. And today, I'm going to be showing you guys all of the eyeshadows that I own in my collection. Before we begin, make sure that you guys hit that subscribe button and become a part of the Sparkle family. Also press on the bell icon that is right beside the subscribe button so that you guys get notified as to whenever I post my videos. So yeah, without further ado, let's get started. So I'm going to be starting off with one of my favorite eyeshadow palettes from Too Faced, and that has to be the Chocolate Bon Bon eyeshadow palette. This is how it looks like. The casing is really nice and sturdy, and it has a magnetic closure as you guys can see. The palette is pink in color, which is a big plus, and all of the eyeshadows come in this heart-shaped pan, which is super adorable. So I'm just going to be swatching a few shades for you guys so that you guys can see the pigmentation. And yeah, so let's just swatch a few shades. These are the swatches of the eyeshadow palette. As you guys can see, it's pretty pigmented. It's just one swipe and it's a dry swatch. Plus, it smells like chocolate as well. Also, moving on to the next product. This is again by Too Faced and it's their Natural Matte Eyeshadow Palette. This is how it looks like. It's really nice and travel friendly. It's the size of my palm. And these are all of the eyeshadows. To be really honest with you guys, I just enjoy a few eyeshadows from this entire collection, and that has to be Strapless, which is right here, and Chocolate Cookie. As you guys can see, I've already made a slight dent in it. I don't know whether you guys can see it, but it's a little... Moving on, from the same brand, there was a Christmas collection that was launched last year. And these palettes are from that Christmas collection. Excuse me for the background noise, you guys. I can't help that. So really sorry if you can hear a little, you know, vehicle noise. So let's just get that out of the way. But these are the three eyeshadow palettes. They look super, super cute. Plus, this is like a cardboard packaging and it has the same magnetic closure. And these eyeshadow palettes are okay-ish. I mean, I just enjoy again a few shades from these. The Peppermint Mocha eyeshadow palette. It has 6 eyeshadows and 1 blush. And the shades that I really like are Peppermint Mocha and Sprinkles. This is Peppermint Mocha and this is Sprinkles. And we have the Eggnog Latte eyeshadow palette. So these have again 6 eyeshadows and 1 blush. So the shades out here that I really, really enjoy are Cold Brew and Central Perk. These are right here. So those are the eyeshadows. Let me just get up and show you guys because these look really pretty. So if you guys can see, aren't these super, super gorgeous? Like, who am I even kidding? Last but not the least, we have Gingerbread Cookie by the same collection. However, this has 6 eyeshadows and 1 bronzer. So the shade that I really like in this palette has to be Ginger Snap and Winter Dream, which is this beautiful gold color and this really, really pretty, like, purplish iridescent color with like a beautiful sheen to it. Last Too Faced eyeshadow palette, which is the Stardust eyeshadow palette by Vegas Name. So they did a collaboration with this Instagrammer and they came out with this really pretty palette. This is how it looks like. All of the shades are really pretty. Tap is a little chalky, but the rest of them are really pretty. Want to see how a few of these eyeshadows perform on the eyes? Then I'll link a makeup tutorial that I uploaded using only Stardust eyeshadows. So now I won't swatch all of the eyeshadows because in the video will become super long and you guys will get bored for sure. So I'll just show you guys all of the eyeshadow palette, and if you want me to do a tutorial using any of these eyeshadows, then you can definitely list them in the comment down below. Moving along, you guys know this eyeshadow palette for sure. It's the Carly Bible eyeshadow palette by BH Cosmetics. And I love all of these shadows. They perform super good. I use them for all occasions, irrespective. And it is super, super gorgeous. As you guys can see, I've literally made a dent on this one. If you guys can see the white one, it's like almost gone. And you guys can see I've literally done a lot of damage on all of these mattes and these beautiful like rose goldy shimmer colors. Like, what even? So I absolutely love this eyeshadow palette. 6 highlight shades and 21 eyeshadows, which is beautiful. It also comes with a beautiful big mirror and it says aspire to inspire, which is my thing, you guys. You know, if you guys have seen my Instagram, you would see the first thing in my bio says, oh, an old school dreamer who wishes to live, love and inspire. So yeah, this palette speaks to me a lot. PH Cosmetics and Carly Bible, you guys nailed it. Next we have two eyeshadows from the Makeup Revolution line. So this is the Makeup Revolution Redemption palette in matte brights, and it has all of these beautiful, like, vibrant colors that I don't use very often, obviously. So that's why there's no dent. It looks as if it's completely new. But I just got this, you know, just in case if I want to do like a really nice bright eye, then I can definitely go for this particular eyeshadow palette. So these are all the bright mattes. I want to swatch this yellow one. Yeah, this looks super good. Even this purple one, actually. Can you see? We have the Makeup Revolution Redemption Palette in Iconic 3. This is a dupe to the Urban Decay Naked 3 Eyeshadow Palette. And these are the colors. They're really nice and pigmented and very, very closely related to the Urban Decay Naked 3 Palette. Next we have the L'Oreal Chocolate Lover Eyeshadow Quad. So this is how the quad looks like. The shades are really pretty, but then the quality of the shadows really disappointed me. These eyeshadows didn't really meet my expectations because I really expected a lot from this established brand, and these are the colors. As you guys can see, it's just not very pigmented and plus it's a little chalky. So I haven't used this eyeshadow palette quite a lot, but I really hope that L'Oreal improves with their formulation for these eyeshadows. Next I have the Maybelline Quad. These were really popular back in the day, and it is the Diamond Glow by Maybelline Eye Studio palette. And I have four quads in the same collection. So this is 02 Wine Pink, the shade 06 Lilac Mauve. This is in the shade 01 Copper Brown. This is in the shade 04 Ocean Blue. Next palette that I own is the Nudes palette by Maybelline New York again. So this was the first eyeshadow palette launched in India by Maybelline, and this is how it looks like. A few shades are chalky, but there are certain shades that look gorgeous on the eyes. So like this shade, as you guys can see the pigmentation, it's pretty darn good. However, this black shade, as you can see, it's kind of chalky. But look at these ones, aren't they super gorgeous? So yeah, that's the nudes for you guys. Next palette that I have is by Savannah Colors, and it is one of their newer palettes, and it's the Rose Gold palette. This is how it looks like. Okay, excuse that slip. But it has this really nice full mirror. And it comes with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6 eyeshadows and 2 face products. So it's in the rose gold edition and the colors are really nice. This is a highlighter and this is a blush. I love this palette for the eyeshadows and how travel friendly and cheap this is. I got this for 430 rupees from Beautiful Lokhandwala. And it is really nice. Plus it's super sturdy, as you guys can see. And it also has a magnetic closure as well. So I was pretty impressed by this palette by Savannah Colors. The last palette that I have from Savannah Colors is their Originality Makeup Palette in 02. This is how the palette looks like. It has a mix of mattes and shimmers. So you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You have 6 mattes and 4 shimmers. This is how it looks like. I use this in my transition quite a lot once upon a time. And also this just to kind of deepen up the eye look. And I actually used to love this palette a lot, but I don't know why I stopped using it. I think you should start using it again. Next we have this palette by Tanya Burr. This is how it looks like. It's in the birthday suit shade. So it has this really pretty like heart shaped mirror. And it has all of these eyeshadows. The eyeshadow quality is okay-ish. I mean, I just got it because it was super cute and my friend was in London, so I just wanted to try one of Tanya Burr's eyeshadow, and this was something that I saw online seemed of my style because it's all neutrals and you know, I'm a neutrals girl, yeah. So I just got this and I honestly didn't quite enjoy it as much. So that was a little... Next we have this eyeshadow palette by iHeart Makeup. This is their Chocolate Wise palette and it looks like chocolate. It is meant to be a dupe for the Too Faced eyeshadow palettes that are the chocolate edition. So, I mean, I don't know whether they're exact dupes or not, but then the shades are really pretty. So, this is how the eyeshadow palette looks like. This smells like chocolate as well, so that's pretty cool. And there are a few shades that I really enjoy. So, for example, this really nice like goldy color. And this like really nice peachy color. Pigmentation is pretty awesome when I do a swatch. I'm just next level, you guys. You guys see? It's really nice. Next we have the Victoria's Secret eyeshadow palette that I got from Beautiful as well. I didn't know Victoria's Secret also made eyeshadows, but the packaging is really nice. It's super sparkly. It has all of the smoky colors that you guys can use when you're going out on a date or going out clubbing or whatever. So a few of the shades are chalky again, but then it's Victoria's Secret. I mean, they specialize in something else altogether. But a few of the shades are really gorgeous, especially this beautiful like blue color and like beautiful like grayish black color. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about, you guys. The pigmentation is super. So I quite enjoy these eyeshadows for a really nice smoky eye. So the next eyeshadow palette that I have is from Day to Day. I got this from Dubai and these are all of the beautiful shades. This is proper neutral palette that will suit Indian skin tone beautifully. At first I was skeptical about the quality of these eyeshadows, but then when I used it I was like... Next we have the Maya Mia palette by Anastasia Beverly Hills. This is my first ABH product. Overall, I didn't quite enjoy the product. First of all, a few shades are super chalky and that is not what ABH really stands for, and they're known for their buttery eyeshadows and beautiful lipsticks and obviously their brow products. I mean, who can forget that? But this palette didn't quite speak to me and I didn't quite enjoy it. So I just liked a few shades out of the bunch and I paid what, like 3000 plus rupees for this palette. I mean, I definitely expected more out of this, but it failed. So a big no to the Maya Mia palette, sadly. And I got the Modern Renaissance palette by ABH because there was so much hype about this product. However, I got my hands on the first copy of it. I didn't get the original product because I didn't know how well it would perform on me. And I didn't want to make an investment because my experience with ABH wasn't very nice. So I was just like, should I give like 3000 plus, like 5000 rupees for a palette? Like, should I just, you know, give it a shot and see how it all goes? So I got the first copy and damn it, I love all the shades. I love how it functions. I mean, being a first copy, the pigmentation is really nice. As you guys can see, I've literally made a slight dent in burnt orange and realgar, something. So yeah, I mean, the shades are super pigmented. Look at that. Look at these shades. Aren't they super gorgeous? Like, I just went head over heels for this and I absolutely love this eyeshadow palette. So when this is done and over with, I'm definitely going to be repurchasing an original ABH Modern Renaissance eyeshadow palette. My shadow palette that I didn't want to invest completely into was the Huda Beauty eyeshadow palette because I had that Modern Renaissance palette and I was like, I mean, the shades are pretty similar and stuff, so I'll just like see how the first copy of it performs. However, when this came to me, it broke during transit, so I couldn't really give the sparkly like pressed eyeshadows a shot. However, the mattes perform quite well, like henna and sandalwood. These two have to be my favorite warm brownie like warm shades. And the rest I couldn't really see how it all functioned because it broke and everything. So I just don't know how overall the eyeshadow palette performs. But looking at Huda's success, I think that it's like all her products are trustworthy. Next we have this Lakme eyeshadow palette that I broke. It's in the Desert Rose shade. I broke it completely, but I love all of the shades in these. I mean, it's super gorgeous and the product is super buttery. Like, look at that, it's literally like a foil. Not even kidding. And it's so soft. I mean, I just I can't even, you guys. Lastly, I have a lot of single eyeshadow, as you guys can see. It's like filled with a lot of neutrals and colorful pops. So I have a few MAC eyeshadows, like these. A few Miss Claire eyeshadows, because Miss Claire is bae. 90 rupees for one eyeshadow, I mean, what even? And the quality is super gorgeous. One Color Bar eyeshadow and one Kiko Milano eyeshadow. I got this because of the top shade. I don't know whether you guys can see. Wait, where is it? Here. I don't know whether you guys can see the sheen or not, but it is super, super gorgeous. Wait, I'll just show it to you on my finger. You guys can see the pearlized, like, iridescent, glittery finish that it has. Super beautiful, super beautiful. Look at that. I don't know what I'm doing with these, but I just want you guys to see like how beautiful this eyeshadow is. Last eyeshadow palette that I have is by Klairs. And this is how it looks like. It's this pressed glitter eyeshadow thing. I just got it as like an eyeshadow topper. That completes my eyeshadow collection, you guys. I know this is a very lengthy video and you had to hear a lot of me talking, but I hope that it actually helped you see all of the eyeshadows that I own in my collection. If you guys have any requests that you want me to do using these eyeshadows in any of my videos, then definitely let me know in the comments below, or DM me on Instagram, message me on Facebook. I'm there everywhere. All of the handles are listed in the bottom bar below. Also guys, let's grow our family, shower the poop love, and reach to 500 subscribers soon and grow our sparkle family. Make sure you guys hit that like button and kind of applaud my efforts. Just kidding. Give it a like if you guys think that you enjoyed this video. That way it just keeps you motivated, you know, makes me want to produce more content for you guys. And yeah, I'll see you guys in my next one. Till then, take care. Have a wonderful, magical, beautiful day. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.